Hey people, what's going on? It's the Obsoletist.
Hey people, what's going on? It's Jamil. And so I just want to tell people some more of my story. Now, basically, I've become like the only person in the world to actually stop the gang stalking program. There was a shadow of the program still running, like reflections, at a very dim level.
In the corner of my eye, in my mind, I was thinking, a concept?
But pretty much what happened was I put the gang stalking program in an extremely tight stranglehold by using...
Uh-oh, I hope by that he doesn't mean the girl.
An entity...
Because the gang stalking program, by the way, is a phrase that he uses a lot to just supplement the word, the phrase mental illness. My schizophrenia... The schizophrenia...
That they were using against me. And the entity was, like, basically the only individual that they felt was going to be able to affect me, and I was able to...
The entity? He's talking about the female. The retarded-ass bitch.
...that entity's consciousness in such a way to where they became inactive. And I didn't know it at the time, but I actually stopped the fucking program. And it was pretty cool. It was pretty fucking cool. I stopped it for, like, 5 days in a stranglehold.
Okay, everyone, just to explain, right, this is a man who's just, you know, he's had his computer, his, why the fuck am I, phone taken by the police. He's up on stalking charges, because he's stalking these women, and what is it? No, it's just all the gang program again, it's still just, it's the gang program.
And everybody knew it, everybody could see it, and... Not only did I stop it, I was fucking humiliating the fuck out of the program.
You were humiliating the fuck out of yourself. The way that you're behaving online was embarrassing. I can't imagine what you were doing in real life. Talking about interracial sexual rituals on his lawn because he was seeding his lawn. You stupid idiot. You fat Nasher from Dennis the Menace. That's what that face is. I've been wondering for years. I was like, who's he remind me of? It's Nasher, the dog from Dennis the Menace. Fat Nasher.
And so they twisted it around and they used a scenario that I was gang stalking people from YouTube. Basically.
No, nobody flipped it around. You mean they watched one of your 1,000 plus videos and they were like, oh yeah, this guy's gang stalking people on YouTube. Jamil, do you know what stalking is? Look up stalking, okay? And then listen back to all your videos of I was following her down lanes, down that dead-end lane. And you're scared to come back up that lane. You know that she knows about you and that she's scared to confront you. And whether in your deluded mind you think that's because she loves you or not, somehow that's saying that she loves you. It's still stalking because... Guess what? The court's gonna take the side of her, this sane person. Because we can't reason with you. We can't help you.
My YouTube videos were pulling such a large, like,
home invasion.
The projection of my energy through the YouTube videos
to the door as you broke in,
affecting people's consciousness in a way to where they were stopping their gang stalking activity. And the program was just like, oh my god, what the fuck? So, I ended up getting arrested on stalking charge based on fucking YouTube videos. Like, pictures of Little Mermaid, and...
Not based on YouTube videos as such. I mean, in a way. But based on what you were telling us was happening in your life, and what you were up to, and what you still do not deny you did.
And all kinds of stuff. It's just fucking crazy, but... Anyhow, so I end up going to the jail, and the police officer that was driving me to the jail, me and him were talking about all this stuff, and he was just like, "Man, why are you on YouTube so much?" And I had to explain my story of my conspiracy stuff from like Jim Jones all the way up to
what a ride. You know, that's the joys of being a policeman, isn't it? You know, I mean, sometimes you have to rough and tussle. Could I sound more punsy? With some criminals, you know, you're getting a shootout, whatever. You gotta go deal with domestics. Find some kid dead. All these horrible things. And then one day you get this absolute crazy guy with this crazy ass story in the back of your car. And you go, oh, really? Yeah, tell me a little bit about that. make the driver a bit more interesting on the way to the station. And he goes on for the rest of his life thinking that that policeman sided with him.
Now, and he's just like, he just, I'm just looking at him, he's just like, damn, all this out of some fucking Jim Jones pictures? And I'm just like, yeah, man.
No, he's not. He's looking at you. Oh my god, it was like that. I'll have to find that video. In fact, we probably haven't. I don't know if we'll have. We might even get round to seeing that video. Look at that weird face, by the way. What's with that face? That is strange. That doesn't even look like Jamil there. But yeah, he did the same thing when it somehow. I don't know how it works, but in America, but he was in jail. Like, not prison, jail. After he'd been arrested, and he was talking to some of the people on there, and he was like, apparently he told them to check out his YouTube account or something, and then some time, period of time passed, and then he came back, and they'd apparently checked out the YouTube account. Well, I don't know how. Like, did they have internet access in there? I don't know. But they were all laughing and that, and he took that. Once again, he takes that as they're thinking, wow, it's so crazy. I can't believe this guy's gone through all this stuff. It's crazy. Why this guy? It's not that, mate. It's the way that you're talking about the woman on your YouTube channel. Your childish fantasies. It's ridiculous. It's laughable. It comes off as like not. I'm comical. I'm funny. You know, I'm kind of wacky. I'm comical. No, you're crazy. You're crazy. You know, comical people you'd let around children. You know, you'd let a comical person. Be a babysitter. They're funny, he's a comical guy, he's funny, he's wacky, but you know what, he's responsible. He's not nuts. Jamil, you're fucking crazy, mate. Like, tapped.
Still grinding off the whole Jim Jones pictures. And like, and so, but I'm telling, I had like a euphoric feeling come over me, and when I got to the gym, I'm just like, I don't know why this is going to serve me, but somehow this is going to serve me. And it has. Now I get to come face to face.
Oh, it served you.
That the people that were unable, the people in the gang psych program that were unable to come face to face with me, now they have to do it under law. And so that's the coolest part about
this. Sure.
Like, the law just came in like, fuck that, give Jamil what he wants, make these motherfuckers come into a courtroom and face him. And so I got that.
And do you think that, I've just got this crazy prediction here. I'm not even sure if the family's going to end up in the courtroom. As he thinks, because of course in his mind, he's got it set up like, it's going to be the OJ trial. Now, Mr. Rawls, your statement. Well, let me put it to the courtroom. No, Jamil, it's going to be like a sausage factory. The meat goes in one end, comes out the other, mostly based on previous cases. You're done, mate. There's going to be none of this, you and the girl finally getting the confrontation. The father's probably not going to want to look at you, or if he is, he's probably going to give you like the angriest stare all the way through the courtroom, which would be a mistake. I'd say if the father's listening to this, you want revenge? You want real revenge if you do end up in court, which, you know, make sure none of you even look at Jamil. Don't look at him. Don't acknowledge the fact that he's there. It will kill him. Okay?
And I know I'm going to come on top no matter what, because I'm going to be the only person in there telling the truth.
Well, to be fair, right, I don't doubt it. Somehow, I've lost complete faith in, like, the American justice system since I've seen this guy's rap sheet. It's like, how's this guy even allowed out? Right, how, with the crimes that he's had before, that he's been arrested for, charged for, home invasion and stuff when he was younger, that stuff is indeed true that I saw, the criminal records. How's this guy allowed, like last time when he was, when the family rang the police about the stalking, about sending the flowers. Like, how did they just go there and give him a warning? Like, this man is a menace to society. Okay, he's not taking his pills, he's not doing whatever he needs to do to not be crazy, or he's incapable of not being crazy, and he's huge, and he's not under the supervision of anybody that can control him.
It's gonna be a fucking. It's gonna be so cool, and I won't be the only person in the world to put the gang stalking program in a courtroom, and or not necessarily the gang stalking program, but gang stalking. So that's cool. But I mean, I don't even know where to start. This is just like a turning point in my life where it's just like everything is out to serve me now. You know, I become a master. I was the only person in the world to actually stop the gang stalking program for using their own people. I didn't stop it using myself. I stopped the fucking program using their own people. And so, it's pretty fucking cool. But, on a side note, though, right now what I'm doing is, I lost my the cops, they took my computer, police took my computer, they took my phone, and so I got hella contacts in my phone that I can't fucking get back now, because they got my fucking phone, and so, I don't know what I'm gonna do. I gotta go through the Verizon records and retrieve numbers and stuff like that. That's gonna be a hell of a task, man. That really fucked me up right there. So, the good thing is it's still summertime. It's not even really the middle of August yet, so I got a lot of summertime left.
No, you don't. See, this is the real fear. Do you know what Jameel, and I'll tell you all in a little secret right here. Do you know what Jameel fears even more than the possible prison and jail time? Winter. Okay? Because summer might have been where bad experiences in the past led to his sudden decline in mental health, such as a girl driving past him with another guy that he'd fallen in love with. But winter is that time in Muskegon. Look at it up. Look up Muskegon, Michigan on a map. Look where it is. It's not a nice place when it's winter. Not a lot of walking about for hundreds of miles for Jameel Rawls. A lot more sitting around mommy's house, reading the internet. And you know what that leads to?
And, you know, I don't know what, man.
Well, in the middle of August, you know, it's getting close. He can lie to himself and say, still plenty of winter left, summer left. I mean, it's September. That's the summer left. September's a weird month. You can get really warm September, but you know, by the time October comes, you know, that's winter. I mean, kind of, you know. Kind of. All right, maybe not. Okay, mate. I remember some kind of warm Octobers and Halloweens, come to think of it, but in England at least, and I'm sure in Muskegon, it's certainly not summer. We're about in autumn-ish. I'm looking out the window right now. There's no brown leaves. Just don't listen to me. I don't know my seasons, obviously.
I'm trying to think. What else do I got going on? What else positive
Nothing.
Came out of this?
Oh, hey Cortana. Pause. But oh, she is shit. No, not that poor. There, she did it anyway. Hey Cortana, stop listening. I can't stand this Cortana thing. Can't stand it. Give me back my Xbox thing. She rubbed it. Hey Cortana, who says hey? And I have to whisper it now. Who says hey Cortana? Who says that? Like, it's such an unnatural thing I have to say every time, rather than just Xbox.
I know there's more positive stuff that's coming out of it. I've been trying to think of what it is. When I got to the jail, I was at the jail, right?
Oh, he's a story.
And one of the guys, like, behind the little thing, and he's like, what'd you do? And I was like, they charged me for stalking. And he was like, who are you stalking? I was like, they charged me for stalking based on some YouTube videos. And he was just like, what? He was like, what's your handle name? I was like, it's my name. I was like, Jameel Rawls. And so there's this other woman there, she was fucking hot, right? And so they're going through my videos, and they're looking at all my videos, and so I'm walking around this thing, and now I end up coming back out to talk to them later on, because they're trying to process me, right? They're trying to fingerprint me all this stuff. And as I come back out, they're just sitting there looking at me, and the woman, she was looking at me, and her face was so red, and she was just sitting there smiling, like she was sitting there trying not to laugh, and she was looking at me, and the guy...
See, there it is. Obviously, I mean, we all know that that's one of two things. One, either the entire thing was just made up in his head, and she didn't even have any reaction whatsoever, and wasn't able to even check out the YouTube videos yet, and he just assumes it, because everything happens in his head. Or two, she did actually see the videos, and they saw what we saw. And yeah, they're criminals, but they're not crazy. They understand how he's coming off.
Like, the guy doing it, he was just like, what the fuck? And so I was like, and then pretty soon, like, all the police in the jail, they all just kept, like, looking at me, like, smiling and laughing and stuff like that. And just like,
out the corner of my eye, I saw them smiling. Out the corner of my eye.
I was, like, taking over the jail. Like, the police were just like, it was so funny, man. The sheriff, they were just like, wow, man, this is fucking crazy.
No, they weren't.
They were like, we never seen anything like this before.
No, they weren't.
And it was just like, it was just so funny, man. It was just like, all the female police, they were like, they were just like, man.
Police eye, mate. Police officers. Police's.
Yeah, he's a character. And so, I don't know. It's kind of funny. It's like, I'm on the internet saying I'm the only person in the world to beat gang stalking, and I ended up getting charged with a stalking charge on gang stalking.
That is kind of funny.
And so I don't know what to make. I mean, it's pretty interesting. It's pretty fucking interesting, and so...
Oh, it's interesting as well. Believe me, we've got a community on it now.
I don't know what to make of it. It's pretty cool. This is like some CNN, MSNBC stuff.
Nah, I don't... Don't really get that comparison at the end there. So that's that video. 6 minutes that I managed to drag out to 16. Let's see. Oh, don't fucking start clicking things. Shut up. Right. Oh, look, there's more of his twerking videos. So that one was that one. I guess we'll go on to this one.
Maybe it was not as Jamil.
Yeah, but it was
one of the biggest things I like to do is watch Muhammad Ali.
And we know.
Watch Muhammad Ali is not just so much about boxing. I enjoy watching boxing, the older fights. Newer boxers don't impress me. I like watching the older fighters. But Muhammad Ali, I got a chance to meet him. And I know.
We know.
I got a chance to meet him when I was like 7. And I went to go
see him. He passed his energy onto me, man. And then he died. How weird's that? He died around the time I started talking about him. What, you mean that guy that was clinging on to life for 7 years?
His hand, he ended up giving me a hug. Now, this is in an area called Muskegon Heights, Michigan. There's a big clock tower on Broadway. And he came here many years ago back then. You know, early 90s. And I got to meet him, and it wasn't until I went to Phoenix.
That is actually kind of funny if you think about it. Muhammad Ali. I look at it more as if, like, not that Jamil got to meet Muhammad Ali. Muhammad Ali got to meet Jamil Rawls. I respect Muhammad Ali and stuff. Well, I mean, you know, I think he's a bit of an anti-white, anti-Western Muslim, you know, but whatever. Love is, you know, I love the character and everything. Love the legend. But give me the choice, and obviously behind, you know, bulletproof glass, and I'd love to meet Jamil Rawls. Much more. I want to pick this guy's brain. What people don't realise in the as well, I need to mention this. I'll write a post about it as well as mentioning it here. The guys in the community, Bizarre World. This guy is mentioned before and read from a journal that he kept. I'm not sure if he still writes in it, but he definitely kept it for a long time. Wrote in it around the entire time when he started going crazy and all that stuff. This guy has a journal, do you understand? And the journal, when he was reading it, he couldn't even bring himself to read certain parts. I will pay any money for that journal. Anything. We need to find a way of getting him to read it, getting him to sell copies of it. He keeps talking about writing a book. We need to convince him that that is the book. Unedited. Raw.
For some reason, he came into my consciousness, and I started studying him, and I realized that this man, me and him have two things in common. We both can manifest. He's able to manifest through his reality and come up with the things that he desires based on his belief, and I'm able to do the same thing. And so...
He's right in a way.
It was inspiring to see that, and right when I started using him as inspiration and putting clips in my videos... It became a situation where the more and more I got inspired about manifesting, then he died. Right after I started using him, he died. And I'm like, man, this is like all meant to be, you know? And so, it's just...
How? narcissistic. How? The man died. And this is all meant to be, man. Because of me. Because I'm coming into my own, is what he means. He took the energy. He's gonna use that energy that helped Ali win the Rumble in the Jungle. He's really gonna use it to bring down the program in the courtroom when they all have to sit there and look him in his eye.
Like a lot of the stuff I grind through, it's like I know spiritually somehow I have some sort of link with him. It's mind blowing. And last night something big happened to me. Last night I was on the phone with my friend Steve, right? Now Steve lives on the West Coast. He lives out on the West Coast. And but me, I was talking on the phone, and for the first time, I actually started talking to the secret societies on the phone. It's like this. My phone is heavily monitored, right? I had to get a new phone. My other phone got
That's gonna be nice. Not only does Steve have to like have these long, drawn out conversations with Jameel every night, where Jameel just doesn't even listen to what Steve's saying, and all he wants to talk about is this girl or whatever's on his mind at that time. Sure, at the moment it's the man, but the court case. You know, Steve talking 20 minutes about some horrible things that happened in his life. Yeah. But you know, the girl I'm talking about, you know, that girl I'm in love with, man, I wanna get back at my house. Just not even, just a one-way conversation. Not only does he have to put up with that, but now probably when, while Jameel's talking to Steve, Jameel just stops talking to Steve. Now he's starting to talk to the program. And by the way, the program, I'm gonna tell you this as well. Oh, great. Oh, great.
Please, but I had to get a new phone, and with this phone, you know, I call people and stuff like that. But there's a lot of different types of people who monitor my phone.
Hang on, what
I
was,
know,
hang on, wait, what?
You know, I call people,
what fatty?
and but me, I was talking on the phone, and for the first time, I actually started talking to the secret
Yeah, not
societies on
that.
the
Come on.
phone. It's like this. My phone is heavily monitored, right? I had to get a new phone. My other phone got
The
done.
fuck? What is this?
Please.
Where did you get that from? Who bought that? This is what annoys me about this sick fuck. Is this guy on government benefits? And if so, he should be cut off. He should be completely. They should be completely restricted. This man is out. He's jogging. He's walking. Is he mentally incapable of handling a job? Well, at the moment, he's criminally insane. So he shouldn't be even near the public. So no. But he shouldn't be in this house either, leeching off the taxpayer this way. He's gonna leech off the taxpayer. I'd want him behind bars. All right? Or at least a very heavily medicated in a very in a white coloured facility.
But I had to get a new phone, and
A new phone? That is, that's annoying me to no end that. Look at that. What is that? Where's it from? It's like a proper phone as well. Not just a little crappy. Look at his stupid face. Doesn't work an hour. Sits in the ear all day. Like a little boy. Fantasizing. Feeding into his insanity. While people out there grind their ass day in, day out to keep this system going that he just sits on. Mate, just go play on the train tracks. How about that? Just go run around on the train tracks.
new phone, and with this phone, you know, I call people and stuff like that. But there's a lot of different types of people who monitor my phone. But I know for
No,
sure
they don't.
the people that I'm closest to that listen to it are a few, are three or four secret societies that are like, you know, they're extremely influential across the world.
Yes, they
And he
are.
said.
But they're not listening to you. Why are they listening to you? You say all the stupidest shit and incriminating stuff on this channel, and you put it out there. If you're even more retarded in private, nobody's even going to want to listen to that. I don't want to hear that. This hurts enough to listen to, okay? I think of myself as quite a logical person. And after one of your videos, I'm like one of the robots from Star Trek. Where you just feed illogical information into it and then its head explodes. I can't do it. I can't do this for too long.
You know what? I'm just gonna start talking to him, and so I start talking to him like I'm talking to Steve. I'll just say, "Yeah, for the secret societies," and I talk to him, and I know they listen. because there's things that have happened. There's things that happened where I know it's coming from what I said on the phone. It's like they show me signs. I'll give an instance. I went to a funeral.
Oh, not the lights on the hearse again.
They had the lights on the hearse. Oh. Now, the gang stalking program likes to use lights on cars in broad daylight. That's something they use.
No! Car manufacturers like to manufacture them like that now. That's what happens. New cars, and the hearse will certainly be new. The side lights come on automatically in the daylight. Because guess what? Even in daylight, sometimes, the middle of the day, sometimes the conditions can be hazardous. You know, sometimes children don't see cars approaching. I don't like it. It annoys me, to be honest. Especially with, like, the Toyotas and stuff like that. They all have those horrible, luminous lights. But guess what? That's just the manufacturing of the cars. It's not gang stalking, you nut.
And so I went to the cemetery, they had the hearse there, and they had the lights on the hearse. I was just like, whoa, this is some Freddy Krueger stuff, right? And so some of the stuff they do has humor to it. You gotta laugh. If you're being gang stalked and you take all this stuff as seriously, I mean, there is moments where these people do have humor. I don't know how it comes across. They do this stuff on purpose, but there is like a humorous side to the gang stalking stuff. And when I saw the lights on the hearse, it was just like, what the fuck? It was just like, oh, I was like, man. And so, but I was talking on the phone with a friend of mine, and I kept telling them,
Steve,
the lights on the hearse. I said it so much, the gang stalking program started using it again. They started using a hearse with lights on it. So my main thing is I want them to drive through the neighborhood with a hearse. I think that would be cool. If they would put, like, lights on a hearse or something and just drive. It was just spooky. I'm like, whoa. And so I know that happened because I was talking it up. Now, that doesn't mean it was a secret society that did it. It could have just been the gang stalking program. But I do talk directly to the secret societies. I know they hear stuff I say. So
yeah, you used to talk directly to aliens. Reptilians from Sirius and Draconian. What are you talking about? You're not talking to anybody. You're talking to Steve. And Steve's talking to you and listening to somebody else in his head. You're talking to Steve and talking to somebody else on the phone. The hell's wrong with both of you?
That's one of the benefits of getting noticed. When I did...
Gang stalking, getting your life ruined. I'm on trial for stalking because of the gang stalkers. This is one of the benefits of getting noticed. Nah.
Stuff I've been through is they're my first audience. And so as they're my first audience, a lot of times when I say stuff or I do YouTube videos, I know they're going to hear it first. Or sometimes I don't think about it like that. Sometimes I'll just be like, fuck it, I don't...
No, they don't. I'll hear it first, man. I'm always on these videos within, like, 8 views. Don't you start talking about the gangs talking about it. I don't get enough credit from this guy. That's what annoys me. Fucking neighbor throwing bread up on the shed roof again. He knows it's going to attract birds. Fucking gang stalkers. Anyway, what was I saying? Oh, yeah. I don't remember. But that's about the end of this video anyway.
But it's pretty interesting, though.
No, it's not.
It's pretty interesting.
No, it's not. Yeah. Here's another video. Hey, everybody, it's Jamil.
And, you know, I was thinking about gang stalking.
Oh, hang on.
Everyone was going on, Jamil.
Ah, well, that was close enough.
I was thinking about gang stalking today a lot. And one thing I realized is gang stalking doesn't really make sense to me in the aspect of why would they spend so much money and so many resources on people who appear to have so little going for them. Like me, myself, I'm 31 years old, I live in my mother's house, I don't have a job, and all I've been doing for the last few years is doing hardcore conspiracy research.
No, you haven't. You haven't! Hardcore research, if you were doing hardcore conspiracy research, you'd be traveling the universities of the country, okay? Getting access to Freemasonic libraries, Okay? It's not that hard to do. It just takes, you know, a willingness to do it. If you really want to do that sort of stuff, you'll get into it. You'll eventually be able to grease some hands and get yourself in and learn about things. What you do is you read things on the internet. You Google image search things like Jim Jones and then make up some crazy conclusions. And you endlessly rant on these videos that you release about 10 a day instead of just doing one long one, which everyone would prefer. This isn't hardcore conspiracy research. This is pissing your life away. Doing nothing. Every day. All day. Skip roping, walking, stalking. Nothing.
And what that got me is that got me put in a situation where I got set up to be killed. And I grinded through that. Then I started running my mouth about it and I got put in the gang stalking program. And I've been grinding through that. And recently, it was like a major, major thing that happened. The area I live in, I was able to put the gang stalking program in a stranglehold and literally put it to a halt for about 5 days and five nights. And that was because my energy that I came to YouTube with, I was communicating through an entity through YouTube, and I actually made them stop the gang stalking. They stopped gang stalking.
Man, that happened. The reason that the gang stalking stopped for 5 days is because instead of obsessing over that with your mental illness, you went full balls deep in with your nuttiness, your obsession with that girl. You say it many times on the interviews you did with Steve during that period of time. Man, I don't even care about the program no more. I'm not even thinking about the program no more. Man, I just need to get back to my house. It's the love of my life, though, my future wife. Retarded ass bitch.
It was just so intense when it happened. I basically shut the gang stalking program down. And so the gang stalking program has managed to turn it around and say I was stalking a whole family from my fucking YouTube videos. And
nobody said that except you. You said it continuously, constantly. Every day you were talking about them, talking about seeing them. I have two next door neighbors. I might see them like once a week. I don't see them all the time. I don't see them all the time because I'm not constantly looking out my window. I'm not looking for them. I'm not trying to find them. I'm not obsessed with them.
It's kind of cool because it's kind of cool because I actually get to come face to face with the gang stalkers now in a court of law. And that's what I had been saying before. I kept saying I want to look these people in the eye. I want to see them in person. All these people. And now it's so cool because it's like the law stepped in like, fuck that, give Jamil what he wants. You know, even though they took my computer and my phone. But recently what I've been learning is gang stalking, I think, has to do with consciousness. And a lot of people say DNA.
Or rather unconsciousness.
But I think DNA...
Subconsciousness.
I think the aspect of DNA is the consciousness in your mind. Because there's all sorts of people. There's elderly people, there's young people, there's black people, white people, Asiatic people, you know.
Nasha.
There's all different types of people around the world who go through gang stalking. It literally happens in South Africa, it happens in England, it happens in Russia, it happens, you know, where I am, Northern Shores, Michigan. And so, for a whole neighborhood to be financially assisted, and them using helicopters, and I live next to an airport, they use airplanes sometimes.
Not financially assisted. You don't have a job. Where do you get your money from? Where did that phone come from? Don't give me this. I have money put away. From what? Get a job, Jamil. You bum.
And it's like Poltergeist. Wherever I go, the gang stalking program goes. And I've been grinding through it hard as fuck. It gets to the point where even people who are going through gang stalking sometimes don't even believe I'm being gang stalked because I'm able to just grind through it so hard I make it look easy. And it didn't really start until I just started saying I beat the program, I beat gang stalking. And when I said that, I believed it, but after I went through it and demonstrated, did the human rights interviews and did all this stuff, it really started manifesting. Now I got people who are gang stalkers coming to me for help. And that's pretty cool. I got clients, I got people who paid me money to assist them. I mean, I've been able to do amazing things with gang stalking. And this has turned into like a thing where it's like the Matrix. You know? Gang stalking is like the Matrix, man. And, you know, I'm 31 years old. I live in my mother's house. I don't have a car. And I was recently arrested for stalking gang stalkers.
Yeah, it's pretty bleak, isn't it?
It makes you really ask questions. Like, I asked myself, like, why when I went to Phoenix, I was in Phoenix for a couple weeks, I was at the Best Western, and I wasn't just experiencing gang stalking there. I actually had people coming from big organizations.
No, you didn't. To study you.
Money is not really real. They have printing presses and they print money. And money's not real.
Well, you realize that then. What was it, like 15 years of research, conspiracy research before he went to Phoenix this year? And you know, I was in Phoenix and I realized money isn't really real. Worked out the con of printing presses of a non-fiat backed currency. Even fiat backed currencies. Just now, Jamil.
It's an illusion. Credit cards, an illusion. Everything's an illusion. So when you see gang stalking, you're thinking they're paying all these people to do all this. Gang stalking program is a program, I think, that's set up for people who have some ability with their vibration, with their frequency, to manifest through reality. Most people are trapped within an illusion.
Oh my God. Really, Mr. Ego? Look how long them alien fingers are, by the way. The hell is that thing? What the hell are those? What the hell is that? It looks like a bean sprout. But yeah, Jamil, mate, you're the one in the delusion. Absolute nuts.
For somebody like myself who kept grinding out of the illusion, grinding out of the illusion, grinding out of the illusion, grinding through conspiracy after conspiracy after conspiracy after conspiracy, then set up to be killed by, you know, people who put the president in the White House, they able to grind through that. And just out here just grinding and manifesting, grinding and manifesting, grinding and manifesting, it's turned into a thing to where people like myself get recognized. They look at me and they say, why is it that the educational system couldn't really stop this guy, the religious system couldn't stop this guy? He's just out there just grinding hard as fuck, you know, spiritually and psychologically. And I've noticed that's the common denominator between me and other people who experience gang stalking. We tend to have like a very creative side. We tend not to buy into the illusion.
Creative? What have you ever created? Just these endless videos. They're not creative. Doesn't matter how many things you string together with Muhammad Ali saying awesome things, being creative, and then slap video of it. That's not creative. Write a book. Release the journal. Release that journal. That's the most creative thing you've ever done. Prove it to us. Give us it. Give me it.
And so it's pretty intense, man. It's pretty intense. This last few weeks has been a real ride for me. It's been pretty cool. And
a couple of rides for you.
You know, a lot of positive things are happening for me now.
Really? So, really?
You know.
You're up on stalking charges, mate, with like a previous record.
I just perceive something good. I don't know how it's going to happen, but I can feel something manifesting out of my current reality. And I can feel a big manifestation coming into being. And everything just being worth everything being... Everything that's been happening has been like put into place just for me to come to this point. And it's like at a pivotal jump point, you know? And so... For people out there...
Russia.
Like, you know, if you can see through the illusion, that means you're the solution. Like, you really don't need me or anybody else to give you advice on how to be gang stalking. All you gotta do is just, you know, think to yourself. I mean, I went through a period where I was hiding.
All right, so never, like, those poor people who paid you $50 a pop. You know, you don't really need any of that. I was just draining you of the resources you have. Probably for his new phone. Because he's disgusting. He's sick in the head. He's a criminal. Attempted home invasions. This man is scum. Absolute scum. And now he's crazy.
Mother's house for a month. And I didn't know it was gang stalking. I thought it was like another hit, another attempt on my life. And so, you know, I went from that to putting the gang stalking program in a stranglehold and making it inactive for like 5 days. And so, you know, the grinding...
Really? Because I remember during those 5 days when you say it was inactive, you talking to Steve like, the program's got the seed, man, seed in the bone. Now the seed man's doing crazy interracial sexual rituals on his lawn. That doesn't sound like you had it in a stranglehold. That sounds like it was doing everything to get under your skin and working. Completely working, even though it was all in your head.
It never stops, man. It never stops. And right now I'm talking about the gang stalking matrix, and it is a matrix. It's like
what's a matrix?
Four guys. Wherever you go, it follows you. You know.
That's not a matrix.
The gang stalking program follows me. You know, and so I just grind through it at whatever level I can. But I want to be the first person in the world to get gang stalkers in court, grind through that. I mean, it's just phenomenal, man.
It's phenomenal. Whoops. That'll look into our secret society right there. Bizarre world. I mean, I could click on that, but it's just a mentally ill delusion. I guess it's probably about it. I mean, you get some twerking videos. The guy's crazy. Let's just watch this a little bit.
Hey people, what's up? It's Jamil. And so I'm outside right now. And the program's still trying to use a mentally retarded bitch against me. And I'm sitting here tripping because I'm like, if you can't use a mentally retarded bitch against me...
This guy spoke to this girl, by the way, apparently once. If you can't tell that she was mentally retarded, Jamil, what's that say about you? And what's with his hair? Like, I've got this theory about Jamil. Watch his videos, right? If he goes away, he gets a haircut, he comes back. And, you know, he's never sane. He's always talking about some delusion he has. But he comes off it in, like, you know, the type of person who's just crazy but harmless. Focused, you know, like when he was working out and everything like that, focused, he has determination, he comes off as at least someone who is capable, and then the longer the hair grows out, just gets messier and crazier. It's like the Samsung of a Samsung of craziness. I mean, if we go right back here, watch, probably better doing it on this screen. Before he went to Phoenix, you know, after our interaction, and I basically ruined his life, he said. And then the police came around because he sent the girl flowers. Let's find those videos. Man, he's done a lot of videos on gang stalking. Right, here we go. There it is. Look at that. Look at this hair. This is before he left for Phoenix.
Okay, now I would like go to away. Go over aluminum. Would you? Now, Freemasonry...
What? He hasn't even... Okay, he wasn't on that video. But, you can see his hair there for some reason. But where's... There was a video... There he is. Look at that. Look at that. This was before his trip to Phoenix, when he realised that the world was gang-stalking him. And came back. This was when his obsession with the girl was at last... at its peak.
For me, wanting your daughter to be happy.
Okay, this was this was March 15th of this year.
It was because I saw a great disconnection in you.
This was one of the first times I remember like seeing him actually talk to the family through the videos. He started doing that a while ago. Like I said before, he left for Phoenix and then he stopped when he came back. But like directly talking to them, and he made quite a few videos like this.
I saw a great unhappiness, and I had never seen that before. Usually when I see her, she's very happy. But after what transpired in the summertime, I saw that it had a great effect on her, like spiritually and psychologically. And I was able to meet eyes with her for a small amount of time, you know. And I saw that, but I also saw that she was expressing an overall compassion. She didn't look at me as being this horrible person or an evil person or a bad person. She was looking at me still with companionship, but also great sadness. And then when I saw that, that's how her heart felt, then it grabbed, I wasn't thinking about this. Like, the 24 hours before that, or even an hour before that, I wasn't thinking about it. But when I saw that's who her, that's where her heart truly was, that grabbed my heart, and that made me feel a great deal of love for her and compassion for her, to still express that kind of connection within all that hurt. And then I saw that her hurt, her disconnection, was stemming to the other elements of the family, was stemming to...
Fucking retarded ass bitch. Fucking stupid whore. Gang stalking. Look at him there. Reptilian, mate. Reptilian of death. Da-dun.
The parents.
Shut up. Shut up. So yeah, Jameel's still crazy. After all these years. Back up here, see if he's released a new one before I click stop on this. Yeah, I apologize for the quality of this video. I just needed to, I needed to cover. Sometimes I just need to cover the videos in between so I don't go too long without a video and sort of lose the narrative. But yeah, keep it up in the community, guys. And I'm sure it's only going to get more fun the closer we get to that court case. Oh, it's going to be great. I'm literally thinking about flying out to America to attend that court case. Oh, it would be glorious. Can you imagine? Can you imagine if they play, not even my video, I don't want to play my videos in court. I want to play his videos in court and we just all sit around watching Jameel videos all day. Be brilliant. Anyway, I'll see y'all later, everyone. Keep up the gang stalking.